Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte promises a review of his bloody drug war before the United Nations. For more on this, we have with us our correspondent, Anjo Bagawisan. Anjo, good morning. What more can you tell us?
Good morning, Mike. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte told the United Nations on Wednesday that he has directed the Philippines Justice Department and the National Police to conduct a review of the conduct of the administration's campaign against illegal drugs. This comes, of course, a week after the International Criminal Court, or ICC, has approved its investigation into the thousands of killings in the so-called drug war. Speaking in his last address as president to the 76th UN General Assembly, Duterte said abuses by law enforcers during anti-drug operations would not go unpunished. The Philippine government has listed over 6,000 people killed in these operations from 2016 to July 2021. But rights groups estimate the number of these deaths, including extrajudicial killings, could reach up to 30,000.
I have instructed the Department of Justice and the Philippine National Police to review the conduct of our campaign against illegal drugs. Those found to have acted beyond bounds during operations shall be made accountable before our laws.
Meaningful change to be enduring must come from within. The imposition of one's will over another, no matter how noble the intent.
Duterte said the Philippine government is finalizing a joint program for human rights that would serve as a model of constructive engagement between sovereign states and the United Nations. He stressed, however, that his government has a mandate and obligation to deal with criminals and terrorists with, quote, the full force of our laws. He added that the Philippines is seeking stronger partnerships with the international community that would, he said, protect the rights of Filipinos and respect the country's sovereignty. This was a position Duterte already reiterated during his first address to the UN General Assembly last year and has harped on in previous pushbacks to the international body's criticism of the drug war. The Philippine government also said it will not cooperate with the ICC's probe.
Meaningful change to be enduring must come from within. The imposition of one's will over another, no matter how noble the intent, has never worked in the past, and it never will be in the future.
President, for the second year in a row, held up the Philippines' victory at the arbitration of the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea in 2016 in asserting peace amid the disputes at the South China Sea. He predicated that by calling on all countries to respect the rule of law and resolve disputes peacefully. Duterte's remarks included an allusion to China, which has been claiming the territory and even built structures on Philippine waters. Duterte also cited the Philippines' humanitarian efforts to allow refugees from Afghanistan and the preparation of a cooperation program with the UN High Commissioner for Refugees for the Rohingya. The president also reiterated his call for the abolition of the kafala or sponsorship system in the Arab Gulf, which he called unjust. Under the system, usually unskilled workers cannot leave without their employer's consent, leading the way to abuse. Duterte's 14-minute long pre-recorded remarks also touched on the COVID-19 pandemic and climate change. He called on developed countries to end what he called the selfish hoarding of vaccines that have caused what he said was a man-made drought of the jabs in poor countries. He highlighted the Philippines' commitment to reducing greenhouse gas emissions by 75% in 2030 and its moratorium on the construction of coal power plants. Duterte said developed countries must fulfill their commitment and called, or what he called, moral obligation to climate action.
Rich countries hoard life-saving vaccines while poor nations wait for trickles. They now talk of booster shots while developing countries consider half doses just to get by. This is shocking beyond belief and must be condemned for what it is, a selfish act that can either be justified rationally or morally. The risks and burden of a warming climate are simply not the same for everyone. The greatest injustice here is that those who suffer the most are those the least responsible for this existential crisis.
Now, Mike, the president ended his speech by slamming the UN Security Council for allegedly violating the UN's values of democracy and transparency in its presentation and process. And his final words to the UN were a call to the international body for reform. He said, if the UN is to lead the world out of the many crises we face, he said, things need to change. Back to you, Mike.
Angel, just about the drug war review, because is the president asking for a new review? Because there's already an existing drug war review. In fact, the DOJ said it has finished two drug war reviews. The first, which it conducted since February 2020, it ended it or finished it December of last year, but until now we're not seeing the report. The second one, about the 52 cases from the PNP files, was finished about weeks ago. Until now, we're not seeing it. The reason supposedly is because the president has not given the go signal to release the report. Now, did you hear any indications or any reference to the results of the drug war review that the president mentioned in this speech before the UN?
No, Mike, the mention of the review on the conduct of the drug war in President Duterte's speech had mentioned no time frame, whether he has already done it, or he has directed the PNP and the Department of Justice to do this in the years before, or if this is just a new order coming on the heels, of course, of the ICC's upcoming investigation into the drug war. So we also seem to indicate, based on the video footage, that this part is a voiceover. The entire part that the president said that he's directing these agencies to conduct a review showed footages instead of the president's face, which is usually shown the entire part of the program. So we, as you mentioned, there are a lot of, there have already been reviews done in the past. And unfortunately, the president has not mentioned any of this. And it seems that this is only a mention on the heels, of course, of the ICC's investigation, which the government, of course, of the Philippines has said that it refuses to cooperate with. Mike.
All right. Thank you for the comprehensive update, Anjo Bagawisan.